Hello, all you beautiful people out there. So today we're discussing yet another important topic, a topic that every woman struggles with in their life. The topic is how to achieve a work-life balance as a woman in business. Let's get this started. At a high level, research showed that achieving a better balance between professional and personal priorities boils down to a combination of reflexivity or questioning assumptions to increase self-awareness and intentional role redefinition. Importantly, our research suggests that this is not a one-time fix, but rather a cycle that we must engage in continuously as our circumstances and priorities evolve. As entrepreneurs, we are running companies, but for many of us, we are also caring for our families or loved ones. When you consider women specifically, according to a research, mothers are spending more time in the labor force than in the past, but also more time on childcare. This shows that we are constantly juggling our commitments and responsibilities, both personally and professionally, which can make finding a balance very difficult. So tip number one, pause and denormalize. Take a step back and ask yourself, what is currently causing me stress, unbalance, or dissatisfaction? How are these circumstances affecting how I perform and engage with my job? How are they impacting my personal life? What am I prioritizing? What am I sacrificing? What is getting lost? Only after you take a mental pause and acknowledge these factors can you begin to tackle them. Tip number two, engage in self-care. Establish boundaries so that you are not taking on extra burdens. Prioritize a relaxation or self-care activity as you are able. Taking care of yourself will help you function best in your roles. Participate in teletherapy if desired and available. Tip number three, pay attention to your emotions. Once you have increased your awareness of your current situation, examine how that situation makes you feel. Ask yourself, do I feel energized, fulfilled, satisfied, or do I feel angry, resentful, sad? For example, one respondent described his realization that his current work-life balance or lack thereof was engendering some pretty negative emotions. A rational understanding of the decisions and priorities driving your life is important, but equally important is emotional reflexivity, that is, the capacity to recognize how a situation is making you feel. Awareness of your emotional state is essential in order to determine the changes you want to make in your work and in your life. Tip number four, become more organized. Create a structured but flexible schedule. Establish dedicated spaces for certain activities like workspace, play space, etc. Simplify your task list into what is the highest priority, allowing for flexibility. Delegate some tasks to others with clear expectations as applicable. Moving on to the fifth tip, share the workload. Delegating is the key. It is the key in achieving a work-life balance. For example, my work in the restoration industry often puts me in situations that demand emergency response. I ease the scheduling crunch by bringing in extra employees who can cover some of my responsibilities. Sharing the workload streamlines everyone's schedule. It makes a positive difference for our customers and it helps us get back to our families a little sooner. However, it's also important to delegate at home too. Women are often responsible for the bulk of household chores, but it's important to remember that you routinely delegate assignments at the office and in the field. So apply that same professional talent to organizing your family. Show them how to pitch in and to be a part of the home team. Tip number six, if you have children, involve them in your planning. Create a structured but flexible schedule and allow your children to make choices about that structure so they have buy-in. Have children FaceTime family members and play games like charades, Pictionary, etc. Set them up with tasks like jigsaw puzzle and set a timer for them. If they do not bother you until the timer goes off, then they get a small reward, ideally a toy or a sticker rather than food. Give them 2 to 3 task options and let them choose which one they want to do. This gives them some autonomy as well. Moving on to the tip number 7, take real timeouts. You work hard all day, so take it easy once you're home. As I mentioned above, make a point to delegate household chores and keep things flexible. For example, I try to cook 4 nights a week. If you schedule a date night with your significant other or plan an evening with friends, keep things casual and relaxing. You can also take things a step further and just take some time to yourself. Remove some of the tension from balancing family and work by giving yourself well-deserved timeouts. Slip away for quiet time that belongs to you and you alone. It could be as simple as sitting down in an empty room and breathing in and out for a few minutes. Do this every day at your office or at your home. Moving on to tip number 8, adapt your attitude. Acknowledge your feelings, positive, negative, and neutral ones. They are all valid and need to be expressed. Lower your expectations. Perfection does not exist, and it is okay if you are not as productive as you think you should be. Be okay with just doing your best with the resources you have. Practice self-compassion. Next is tip number 9, network with purpose. To give yourself more breathing room between your personal and your professional life, track your attendance to luncheons, conferences, and award ceremonies. Add up the time you spend networking or attending various events. Compile a list of events you participate in over a month, and there you will have an eye-opener. You can know how much time you were losing unnecessarily. As a result, learn the importance of learning to say no. Spend some time determining your long-term personal and professional goals. If an event does not serve these goals, there's really no need to attend it. Doing this has allowed many of us to focus on attending events that are important without losing time in the personal life. Point number 10, stay connected. Evaluate who you want to invest your energy in and what formats of connection like FaceTime, social media are most rewarding for you. Have a weekly check-in meeting with a friend or family member who is experiencing similar challenges at home. With this, we move on to the last part of this video. Stop trying so hard. Finally realize that trying to create harmony between your personal and professional life wasn't supposed to be a full-time job. Also learn how not to let one bad day cloud the rest of the week. Believe finding a work-life balance is easier when you stop worrying about it. Give yourself permission to let go of perfection. It's okay to relax and stop trying so hard. So that's it from me, folks, today. If you have liked this video and the other videos on this channel, I request you to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification icon. You can also follow me on various other social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. Thank you for watching.